Okay, so this is the quiz for the week. It's all on the back side of your spiral review. I can use all of this with all my papers that I did this week to answer it, to help me answer any of these. Because there's a lot of room here, I can kind of just answer it right here on this page. To follow the order of operations, we do 3 times 7, which is 21. And then I bring down the 64 minus 21. 2 times, and then that's 3 squared plus this. Then 64 minus 21 is 40.
It's three cubed.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Okay, so 2 times 43. And then 3 cubed is like saying 3 times 3 times 3. 3 times 3 is 9, 9 times 3 is 27. So I'm gonna bring down the 27. Plus 2 times 43. 2 times 43 is 86. So 27 plus 86 is 113. You could have done your work on a separate sheet of paper, but make sure you put your answer back on the quiz page also. Number two, I'm just going to use this graph. Plot the following points to create a rectangle. Find the missing vertex. Over 4, up 3. 1, 2, 3. Make it dark so I can see it when you guys take the picture of those. Negative 5, positive 3. Go back to negative 5, left to negative 5, up to 3. 1, 2, 3. Negative 5. Negative 1. So then my other number will be positive 5, negative 1. Yes. Write the coordinates also. I also want you to write the coordinates on there. John places a point on a coordinate plane at negative 1, negative 12. He wants to place another point across the y-axis, and it must be 11 points. Where will John place the other point? That's very important that it has to be across the y-axis. This one, I draw my little graph down here, and because there's not that much room, I can't make it very big. So it goes negative 1, and I'm just gonna say down here, I can get down here, and that's a negative 12. Okay, so here's my dot. So it's negative 1, negative 12. Label your axis. This is x, this is y. So it has to go across the y-axis. And I need to go 11 points. If I'm here at a negative 1 to get to the 0, how many more do I need to go? How many more?
10.
So I need to go, because this would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and go one more to make it 11. And then if I count from this 0, this is 0, and it goes up to the 10. So my number is it's positive 10, because I go to the right 10, negative 1. Wait. Negative 12.
Yeah.
I'm like, what am I doing here? I'm like, that number couldn't have changed. Because the y doesn't change, only the x, because I was going across the y-axis. 5.5 quarts, 2 pints. Knowing your big G and the 4 Qs, right? Remember that? You should write it again. So I have 5.5 quarts. Equals, well, there's 2 pints and 1 quart. So I just multiply 5.5 times 2. You have to, bless you. Write it up and down. So this is 10, 11. Here's my one decimal. So my final answer is 11. How long will it take you to ski a distance of 24 miles at a speed of 6 miles per 30 minutes? Do you guys notice all of these problems are ones that we had this week?
Yeah.
So if you go back to your notes, it'll help you when you're trying to fill it out. 6 miles per 30 minutes. And I want to go 24 miles. So how many minutes would that be? You can do some of this in your head, right? Like, because if I'm making an equivalent fraction, I can say 6 times 4 is 24, right? So 30 times 4 is 120. Or I want to see it like this. Cross, let's get rid of that. Cross cancellation. So now I have 30 times 24 equals 6x. 30 times 24 is 720 equals 6x. Divide by 6, divide by 6, and x equals 120. But that's minutes. And I told you last week, or earlier this week, if it's over 60 minutes, change it to hours. So I need to take 120, divide it by what? 60, and I get 2 hours. That is your final answer. Determine two numbers that have a product of 40, but have a sum of 13. So if I'm trying to find the products, I'm going to find the factors of 40. So I have 1 and 40. Well, they don't add because the sum is adding to 13. 2 and 20. They don't add to 13. 4 and 10. They don't add to 13. 5 and 8. Is 5 plus 8 13? So your factors are 5 and 8. Use the diagram below to find the solution for 1.5 minus 3 and place a point on your answer. When you're adding or subtracting integers, you always start at 0. And then I go to my first number. My first number is 1.5. So I start at 0 and I go up to 1.5.
Oh,
thank you. So I'll show you that again. It's you start at 0 and you go up to 1.5. I'm going to make that a little bit lower because then the next time you do it, you have to be on top of it. So I wish there was a little bit more space. So then I start here and I'm going to subtract 3. So when you subtract on a number line, do you go left or right? Left. So I need to go 3. If I go a tick mark, that's only a half. So 2 ticks would be 1 whole. So that's 1, 2, 3. So my final answer is a negative 1.5. I'm going to show it to you also. Minus 3 without using the number line. I have a positive and a negative. When you have a positive and a negative, you subtract. So I take 3 minus 1.5. 3 becomes a 2. This becomes 2 halves. 2 minus 1 is 1/2. 2 minus 1 is 1. The 3 was negative. So you take the sign of the bigger number. So then it just becomes negative 1.5. And 8, we need to simplify. We are adding. Okay, so I can go left to right, or I can combine what I have alike. I have 2 negative numbers here, so I'm going to add them together first. So I have a negative 6 plus a negative 4 and 25 hundredths. So that adds up to a negative 10 and 25 hundredths. Bring down the 1 and 3 tenths plus a negative. If I'm adding a negative and a positive, I subtract. So I take 10.25 minus 1.3. Make sure you're lining up your decimals. 5 minus 0 is 5. I have to borrow 12 minus 3 is 9. 9 minus 1 is 8. So you subtract, and then you take the sign of the bigger number. 1 or 10, which one's bigger? So then it is a negative 8 and 95 hundredths. What I want you to do is, let's say I missed number 4, so I put an X on it, and I fixed it. Let's say I missed number 5, I'm going to put an X on it. So then I'm going to take my number that I missed and subtract that from 10, because I'm giving two bonus points, because there's only 8 problems, but I'm giving you 10 points for it. So I'm going to take 10 minus 2, and what's going to be my points then? What's my point?
8.
Okay, so on the top, I'm going to put plus 8 out of 10, and I'm going to put a box or a circle around it. So you take what you missed, subtract that from 10, and that's how many points you're going to get. So yes, this is, you would think it's out of 8, but it's not, because I'm giving you 2 bonus points. So if I missed 2, I got an 80%. What you're going to do now is take a picture of this page and any other work that you did, but I want this one submitted first with your score, and you're going to submit that to Friday, August 29th, Bellworth.